So like I said, I've lost people that was dear to me. I don't even look at that like, yo, own it. Whatever, you want to put on pink today, own it. Just be the best, flyest pink dude out there. Why do women get to smell edible? Like, I want to smell edible too. Give me some Mice Man cologne. I'm going to Vicky's Secret too. They got the best selection. I want to smell good. When I walk by, I want to be like, okay, why? Why just women? Why we got to walk by and smell like musk? No, man, I'm going to smell and look the way I want to. If she dig it, oh well.
As a young man, I had chronic acne. You really have to have belief in who you are as a person, not a depiction of what someone says you are. Self-love is very important. And I think as we talk to our young men about how they identify themselves, it's how you create who you are, not what you read about yourself, not what someone tells you is beautiful or is smart. You just gotta have a strong belief in who you are. You are good enough without someone else's validation.
I think the notion of toxic masculinity is a topic that's being talked about now. We're finally opening up as a society to be able to recognize it. I think for so long we hadn't. And that's what starts like oppression and suppression in the realm of destruction a lot of times. I look at it like something that is a sickness. For so long, you're taught, yo, you can't cry, you know, you play ball, it's a hard foul, it's all these different things. But it's just understanding when you need to step up into a position and also knowing when to be empathetic to other people and yourself.
Well, I think we're living in an interesting time where there is a lot of toxic masculinity, but I think particularly the millennials and Gen Z are really pushing against that and pushing back with their gender fluidity and kind of non-binary and sexually non-conforming identities. And I think it's really cool. I think it's a great time for change. And I consider myself very liberal and open-minded. And I've had to check myself on my patriarchy and hyper-masculine ideas that I grew up with. But we're living in a new day and age. We have a lot of conversations about pronouns and how you identify people. And that has been kind of tough for me because I've had to kind of reprogram my mind on how I address people, but how people want to be addressed and being respectful for that. So the biggest thing for me has been, I say you guys a lot, and I'm fighting against that. I was wearing a rubber band for a while where whenever I said guys, I would snap the rubber band, but now I say y'all or folks. But it's tough, especially as you're older, to kind of reprogram your thinking of something that you just grew up thinking that it was okay, but it's actually not.